In this tutorial, I would like to talk about scaling as well as keyframing. And in order to do so, I've prepared a small project with two screens. Both are 4K resolution, as you can see. And I've put some basic content on here, so two pictures. One which is of full HD resolution, and the second one is of 7680 by 2160 pixels. If you put something onto a screen or onto a layer, you can find the scale unit modes by right-clicking onto a layer and selecting scale unit modes, or directly in your layer settings. And those always determine how content is being put onto a screen. Fit here is our standard setting, and it influences how content is basically scaled. So in my case here, for my full HD video on my 4K screen, fit of course will fit it into the complete screen. Resource resolution, on the other hand, for example, would just put in the file with its native resource resolution. So a full HD file in a 4K screen. On our 21:9 content, this looks a little bit different. So in here, our fits will just basically fit the file into our 16:9 screen. Resource resolution, on the other hand, would do something like that. So it would put the file in by its native resolution. And now if we dive in, we now get access into our inner compositing. You can find the option here on the top or by pressing D. We now are in Pixera's inner compositing, and as you can see, in this compositing space, we now see the whole file, even if it expands or stretches out of our screens. And now here we can take a deeper look on our scaling modes as well. So I will now change here on my 21:9 file from resource resolution to stretch to home screen, which will just simply stretch it. And then again, fit. And last but not least, fill. Same for our 16:9 video, resource resolution, stretch to home screen, and stretch, fit, as well as fill in this case, will do the same action as it is a 16:9 video onto a 16:9 screen. When it comes to keyframing, there are two workflow approaches you can choose from in Pixera. The first one involves your layers. So if you expand the layer, you can find your position, rotation, and size control for your media. And let's go here into size. And if I wanted to add a keyframe, all I have to do is just simply double click here into my width field. And I can now change this value by holding my mouse and dragging it up and down. Or I could just simply put in a value here by hands. Same for height. However, if I don't want to add keyframes manually, I can also add keyframes by simply changing my values in here. So I could, for example, also use mathematical functions here. So let's divide by 4. Same for half. And now, as you can see, as I've changed those values, we have got active values set in Pixera. That's why we have those yellow indicators here on front of our layer. Now I can move my locator to the position I want to store my keyframes, and all I have to do now is click this yellow button, which will simply store my active values. Our second workflow approach accessible in Pixera for keyframing is our so-called in-screen editing. So instead of putting in my changes on my layer, I can also grab my logo right here in our screen. And as you can see, as I change my position here in the inspector, the layer key values are being changed immediately. Same also goes for our layer values. So here our position values are also being changed, and as soon as I'm satisfied with my end result, all I have to do is press our yellow button here. So that's basically the same button which we've used before, and this will now store all the keyframes. As you can see here now, on my located position, keyframes are being stored. Now, if I wanted to move content or my logo in that case out of my screen, as you can see, as soon as I move it out of the screen, it isn't displayed anymore. That's why we have in Pixera our so-called concepts of inner compositing as well as outer compositing. And what you see here right now is our outer compositing mode, which we from time to time like to refer to as scene view. So basically, this is displaying or mimicking the scenery which you have on in your real world. And also, if I would move content out of my real world screen, it of course also won't show. That's why you don't see it here. However, if I would like to use space out of my screen in order to keyframe it or to move content on my second screen, you can now dive in, which you can activate again here on the top. And as you can see now, here I can use all the available space and do whatever I would like to. So now let's do something like that. For example, I store now the keyframe by pressing S. Let's go here on my timeline, for example. Now let's put the logo here. Again, press S to store. And again, let's go here and store again. And as you can see now, we get a small transition. And same for our second logo. Let's start something like here. Then let's go here. And let's go here. And let's dive out. And as you can see now, I've utilized the inner compositing in order to do keyframing beyond my physical screen's space.
Thank you for watching.